In that environment, this creature, Satan, had not yet seen the hell. He didn't know the fear of Allah. Allah showed Satan the hell later, and also to Adam and Eve. Therefore, Adam and Eve sinned. That is, they believed what he said. But they should have been determined about their attachment to Allah and His Word. For some reason, with a purpose, their minds and their hearts moved towards Satan's words. But after, they saw the fear of Allah, and after, they saw the hell and understood the existence of hell. And after they had come to understand that this world is a testing place, all their attitude have changed. Their whole makeup changed. This is because they were very comfortable in paradise. There is food and drink and everything else. Their clothes were appropriate. But when Allah sent them down to earth, as Allah states in a verse, their private parts were disclosed to them, and they began to have natural needs. Even as it is stated in an account, Adam wept and he saw the situation. Allah made him feel the feeling of regret and he understood what pain and suffering were. In this situation, he felt the fear of Allah even more. After that, his character improved greatly. But Satan was a classic psychopath, and we can detect this also in human beings. Tell all the truth you want. Speak as sweetly as you want. The Satan continues that bloodless, amoral character peculiar to a harlot. Satan has the classic character of a prostitute. That is, he has the character of a harlot. That is, an emotional character of a harlot. He says he fears Allah and even thinks to advise him, Allah forbid. And all this within the spirit of a harlot. It is strange. This goes on forever. Then he acts with treachery. He says to his followers, I have not called you. You came on your own. Of course. He says he fears Allah, but he's a total psychopath, a classical psychopath. He is the same as the psychopaths you see on the street. There is no difference in their character. Allah forbid, he approaches Allah with the emotional and crazed mind of a harlot. He says about Adam, you created Adam from mud and me from fire. Therefore, he is lower than I am. He says Adam is ordinary. He is mud, and I am fire. That blockhead advises Allah. He says, even though it is Allah who created, I will not bow down to him. That is, he is arrogant and prideful. That blockhead doesn't know that it is his destiny, but still he tries to make Allah. Allah is beyond that regret. But Allah shows him his Mahdis, prophets, and his faithful believers. When he sees them, Satan burns. For example, Allah says, look, they also know what you know, but they bow down before me. They serve me. Every time Satan sees believers bowing before Allah, it plunges him into deep sadness. For this reason, Muslims must be very meticulous in fulfilling their regular prayers. In other words, a Muslim shows him that Allah speaks the truth. This shows that Allah tells the truth. For example, with his very act of obedience and reverence, a Muslim disproves the Satan.
A Muslim sides with Allah.
Yes. That is because Satan says that everyone is like him. Allah says this is not true. Allah says that his faithful servants will be obedient to him. And what Almighty Allah says becomes to be true. For example, we are obedient and submissive to Allah. We bow down before Him, prostrate before Him. If Allah tells me to throw myself into the fire, I would do it without the blink of eye. But Satan would not. He's a bad-tempered creature. For this reason, Allah has created such a testing system. But Allah is the Almighty. If He had willed to do so, He would not have created Satan. He would have made Satan prostrate before Him. If Allah had willed, He would break his mouth and nose. Satan would not have the power to do all these. But for the sake of testing, we are in need of this, in order for us to know the value of paradise. We need this for the sake of the fear of Allah. Allah has established a wonderful system. Satan is needed in this wonderful system. So it was necessary for Satan to be created. But there's a particular way of life containing all the elements that belong to his life. For this reason, a believer's heart may be secure. All believers are in paradise. Unbelievers, on the other hand, are in hell. But every time believers see them in hell, they will more appreciate paradise. This is very important. In a verse, Allah states this. I take shelter in Allah from Satan. Allah says, why should Allah punish you if you are thankful and have faith?